What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another PL SQL tutorial. Today in this tutorial, we will learn how to do bulk data processing using for all statement with values of bound clause in Oracle database. So far, we have learned how to use for all statement with a dense collection using lower and upper bound clause and a sparse collection using indices of bound clause. What if we want to use for all statement only with selected elements of the collection? Can we do that? Yes, we can easily do that using for all statement with the third and last bound clause, that is values of. For all statement is all about binding the collection elements with a single DML statement in an optimized manner. Using values of bound clause of for all statement, we can bind the selected elements of the collection with the DML statement. Values of bound clause will require two collections. The first collection will be the source collection. We will be doing DML operations such as insert, delete, or update on the data of this collection using for all statement. The second collection will be the indexing collection, which will specify the index number of the selected elements from the first collection. These selected elements will be those elements over which you want to perform the DML operations. This indexing collection must be a nested table or an associative array. If it is an associative array, then it must be indexed by PLS underscore integer or binary underscore integer. You can read more about the restrictions of values of bound clause on the blog. Link is in the description. Now, let's do the example and learn how to properly use values of a bound clause with for all statement in Oracle database. As we all know that, for all statement takes the data from the collection and stores it into a table. So let's first create the table. Here we have our create table statement using which we are creating a table with name tut underscore 79, which has only one column, selected underscore data of number data type. Again, we will try to keep the code as simple as possible so that we can learn and understand the concepts clearly. Let's execute and create this table. Table created. Now that we have our table ready, let's jump ahead and write the PL SQL block where we will see how to use values of with for all statement. Let's do this on a new worksheet. Great. Let's see what we just did here. In the starting of the declaration section of our PL SQL block, I have created a nested table with the name my underscore nested table, which can hold data of number data type. Then in the second line, I have created its collection variable with the name source underscore col. Using this collection variable, we have initialized the first 10 indexes of our nested table. This collection will act as the source collection for our for all statement. Okay, unlike the cases which we have seen in the last two tutorials, this time I want to insert only the 3rd, 7th, 8th and the 10th element of this collection into the table tut underscore 79 which we just created. So next, we will create another collection which will act as our indexing collection. Using this collection, we will limit our for all statement to execute only for the 3rd, 7th, 8th, and the 10th element. Let's do it. Here is our indexing collection. The data type of the element which it can hold is PLS underscore integer, which is also the data type of its indexing elements. In the next line, we have created its collection variable with the name index_col. Now that we have declared both the required collections, the source collection and the indexing collection, next we will write the execution section. Here we will first initialize our indexing collection with those index numbers of source collection whose data we want to fetch and store into the table tut_79. Let's do it. Here we have initialized our indexing collection by storing 4 records into it. Here it is clearly visible that our indexing collection is a sparse collection because we have not initialized it in a consecutive manner. We have stored the first record at index 1 while the second record at index 5. Similarly, the third record at index 12 and the fourth record at index 28. But if you want, you can store these records in a sequential manner too. It is completely your choice because number of index where you store the data in your indexing collection does not matter. The data which you are storing into your indexing collection matters. If you remember, earlier we decided that we want to execute our for all statement only for fetching the data from index number 3, 7, 8 and 10 of our source collection. Now take a look at the data we stored into the indexing collection. Yes, the data we stored into our indexing collections are 3, 7, 8 and 10. These are the number of indexes of our source collection from which we want to fetch the data. Now, we will use this collection in our for all statement using values of bound clause. Let's do it then. Here is our for all statement. Let's see what we did here. The statement starts with the keyword for all, followed by a variable idx. This is an implicitly declared loop index. Then we have another keyword in, using which we are specifying our bound clause, which is values of. After writing the reserved phrase values of, we have specified the collection variable of our indexing collection, which is index_col. Then we have our insert DML, using which we are inserting the records from our source collection, which is referenced here through its collection variable source_col into the table tut_79. You just have to remember that we use the source collection into our DML statement while we use our indexing collection with the values of a bound clause. On execution, this for all statement will fetch the data from index 3, 7, 8 and 10 from the source collection, which is 27, 63, 72 and 90, and store it into the table tut_79. Which means after execution, we must find 27, 63, 72 and 90 stored into our table tut_79. So let's execute this program and check the result. But before that, let's quickly check whether the table tut_79 is empty or not. Although it should be as we just created it. But still, let's do this in a new worksheet. Here we go. No row selected, which means the table is empty. So now let's get back to our program and execute it. Here is our program. Let's execute it. We have an error, which means something is wrong somewhere. Let's see what is it. We forgot to put the semicolon here. Now let's try to execute this program once again. But first, let's close this output panel. Now let's execute it. PLSQL procedure successfully completed. Which means if we check our table again, then we must find the above mentioned records there. So let's check it out. Here is our desired data. So that is how we work with values of bound clause with for all statement in Oracle database. You can read more about this same topic in detail on my blog. Link will be in the description. And if you still have some doubts, then you can comment down below or reach out to me on my Facebook or Twitter. All my contact information is also in the description. And if you enjoyed watching, then give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends on your social media. Also, if you are new to my channel, then subscribe. Because in the next tutorial, we will be learning something new. Thanks for watching. This is PL SQL tutorial on how to use for all statement with values of bound clause in Oracle database by Manish Sharma from rebellionrider.com.